With the release of Forest Pack 7, we can now scatter basically everything. From geometry to lights and even VDB objects. In this video, we'll use these new features to scatter lamp posts with light objects inside and clouds in the sky. Here, you can see the final result. I'm using Corona Renderer 6 for this scene, and although the difference between a Corona light and Corona light material is quite small, sometimes you may need to scatter actual light objects instead of a mesh with a light material applied on it. Before starting, I've set the project file to meters to facilitate the scattering of the clouds. Since they are quite big, it's easier to input values in meters rather than centimeters. The VDB files for the clouds are imported with the Corona volume grid. I won't cover the workflow on how to do it and how to set up the parameters to render the clouds because we'll look into it later. I will focus on the scattering for the clouds and lamp posts, highlighting some notes while I show you what I did. The scene itself is pretty basic, it's a plane with some noise on it. There are a few splines that control the gravel path, also used to scatter the lamp posts, the benches, and the trash cans. The scattering for the vegetation, grass, and trees is quite standard. I used a mix of different assets and distribution maps to scatter the vegetation around where I needed. Scattering lights is done in the same way as geometry. You add the light object from the geometry rollout. The area can be specified with a spline or a surface, and all the distribution modes are supported. Here you can see how it works on a simple setup. First, you've to create the object. I'm working with Corona, so I'll create a Corona light from the toolbar, set it to sphere, and I'll leave the other parameters to their default values. Maybe change the radius to 3 centimeters. Then, you've to create the area for the scattering. In this case, I'll create a simple rectangle. After, you can create the forest pack object and assign the light. If the light is an independent object, you can just pick it. Otherwise, if it's part of a group, you need to select the group using the Add Multiple option. Adjust the distribution. In this example, I'm using the default dense map. A few notes about using groups. In the scene you saw previously, I'm scattering a lamp post that is a group made by the mesh and a corona light on top. Here it's represented by a cone and the light object. If you work in this way, you need to place the pivot of the light object in order to match the pivot of the mesh, otherwise the light instances won't be placed correctly in the forest pack object. This happens only if you have a surface linked in the forest pack object. In case you are using of just a spline, you won't get this issue. If you enable the random transform, the light object may not behave the same way as the mesh. You can see here that there is a misalignment between the lamp post and the corona light. These issues will probably be resolved in a future update. If you used Forest Pack before, you know there is a map, called Forest Color, that we can use to randomize texture on the instances. Luckily, we can also use it to randomize the color or temperature of the light instances. You just need to connect it to the color slot of the Corona light and set the parameters in the material editor. The lamp posts in the scene are scattered using the path distribution with a spacing of 6 meters and an offset of 2.5 meters. This way, they don't overlap with the gravels on the path. To complete the scene, I also added some benches and a few trash cans. Now, we can move on how to scatter the VDB objects for the clouds. As before, the workflow is pretty straightforward. First, create the area where you want to scatter the clouds. Second, create the Forest Pack object and adjust the distribution to avoid scattering millions of objects right away. Third, link the objects in the geometry rollout. As you may have noticed, the VDB instances are not visible when scattered with Forest Pack, even after changing the settings in the display rollout. This is because we need to tell Forest Pack that we are using a non-geometric object. To do it, go in the geometry rollout. Select the object and enable the checkbox non-geometric object. Now, if I set the display mode to points cloud, it's easier to see the distribution and set it properly. The distribution for the clouds is nothing fancy. In this case, I'm using the image mode to specify where I want the clouds, and since they are quite big, the unit's value will be quite big as well, unless you want to create a completely cloudy sky. You can create multiple layers of clouds by simply adding multiple splines in the Forest Pack object. Please notice that with Forest Pack 7, the instances can now follow the height of each spline instead of only the higher one. As always, remember to enable the random transforms. They help a lot breaking the repetition and creating a more natural result. For the clouds, I'm using pretty standard parameters. As I said before, clouds are quite big. For example, the cloud I'm using right now is around 200 by 300 meters in size, so in the random translation, you need to increase quite a lot the values if you want to affect the position of the instances. In my case, I've set the range from -10,000% to +10,000%. All that remains is to launch the render. I've only changed the secondary solver to path tracing and set the noise level to 2%. I'm also using distributed rendering to get a quicker result. Here the same scene, during daylight. A word of caution when scattering volumetric objects. Even though all the clouds we have in the scene are instances of a single source object, the shading computation during rendering will have a big hit on the performances. So, be careful. Don't try to scatter hundreds of clouds right away, or your computer will likely freeze. I tried. Stick around for the next video, where we'll take a more in-depth look at how to render the clouds with Corona 6, and look at how to control the parameters to reach the desired result. We'll also discuss how to create the mesh and the VDB file for the cloud itself, explaining some of the attributes needed in the VDB object to correctly render the cloud. Thanks for watching.